J.J. Watt has won NFL Defensive Player of the Year 3 times, but last season, it was his younger brother T.J. who nearly took home the award. Racking in 13 sacks in 2018 and 14.5 in 2019, he has become one of the league's top defensive talents. The outside linebacker struggled with injuries at Wisconsin before coming to the pros, but has succeeded since making the jump. Watt is only 3 seasons into his career and has years to dominate the league in the future. This takes us back to the 2017 NFL Draft, where he wasn't taken until the 30th pick by the Pittsburgh Steelers. This is who was drafted before T.J. Watt. Before we dive into those selected before Watt, let's take a look at how he's gotten to where he is today. Trent Jordan Watt, or TJ for short, was born on October 11th, 1994 in Pulaski, Wisconsin. As you may know, TJ is one of 3 siblings who have all made it to the grand stage that is the NFL. He is the youngest of 3 siblings, with the other 2 attending Wisconsin. The oldest, JJ, is a defensive end for the Houston Texans. He is a 5-time first team All-Pro and has won the NFL Defensive Player of the Year 3 times. If you're watching this, you probably know who J.J. Watt is, and if you're interested on the players drafted before him, you can click on the link down in the description after the video. The second oldest, Derek, is a fullback for the Los Angeles Chargers and was a 6th-round pick in 2016. T.J. Watt was a rated 3-star recruit coming out of high school. He committed to Wisconsin as a tight end recruit. Watt had a rough road to success at Wisconsin. He redshirted his first year with the Badgers and missed the entire next season with a knee injury. Coming into his 3rd season at Wisconsin, Watt was asked by head coach Paul Christ to switch to a defensive position. He accepted and had to learn to play outside linebacker. That same offseason, he suffered another knee injury and had to undergo surgery. He recovered and returned to play in September of 2015, playing in his first football game since October 2012. Watt played a reserve role in his redshirt sophomore season, recording 7 tackles. After 3 years at Wisconsin, Watt had appeared in 8 games with 7 tackles, but he was soon to break out in his redshirt junior season. Finally healthy for a full season, Watt won the starting job and excelled in the role for the Badgers, recording 63 tackles and 11.5 sacks. He was named first team All Big Ten and decided to forego his final season of eligibility for the 2017 NFL Draft. Watt received an invite to the NFL Combine and completed every drill. In addition, he attended Wisconsin's Pro Day. He is a tireless worker who pursues from snap to whistle, and his brother, JJ, will be a tremendous resource for technique and pass rush plan, Scout said, adding that he is a long-limbed effort rusher who posted impressive numbers against the run and pass in just 1 year as a starter. Watt was projected to be a late first or early second round pick and was ranked between the 2nd and 4th best outside linebacker in the draft. Watt was taken with the 30th selection at the draft by the Pittsburgh Steelers. Joey Porter, the Steelers linebackers coach, had led Watt's positional drills at his pro day at Wisconsin. Watt competed with veteran James Harrison in training camp, later being named the starting right outside linebacker. He quickly made an impact in the pros, putting together an extremely successful NFL debut. Against the Browns in week 1 of his rookie campaign, Watt had 7 tackles, 2 sacks, and an interception. He missed a single game on the season with a groin injury, the only game he's missed thus far in his pro career. Watt broke the franchise record for sacks by a rookie with 7, adding 54 tackles. He was named to the PFWA All-Rookie Team. For the 2018 season, Watt started at outside linebacker alongside Bud Dupree. He excelled in the season opener once again, making 10 tackles, 3 sacks, and blocking a field goal against the Browns. He started in every game, making 68 tackles, 13 sacks, and forcing 6 fumbles. Watt made his first career Pro Bowl. Watt had plenty of success during his sophomore campaign, but the best was yet to come for the young stud. Simply put, he dominated from beginning to end of 2019. He earned AFC Defensive Player of the Month in November and was nominated for NFL Defensive Player of the Year, where he finished 3rd behind Stephon Gilmore and Chandler Jones. Watt had 55 tackles, 14.5 sacks, 8 forced fumbles, and 2 interceptions. He made the Pro Bowl once again and was a first team All-Pro selection. It's safe to say that T.J. Watt has quickly become a top defensive player in the league. Now, let's look at those taken over Watt. With the 13th pick in the 2017 NFL Draft, the Arizona Cardinals selected Temple linebacker Hassan Reddick. Reddick attended Haddon Heights High School in New Jersey, playing safety and running back on the Garnets football team. As a senior, he played in only 4 games due to a fractured femur. He walked on to Temple the following year, redshirting and later playing safety and running back before making a switch over to defensive end. Reddick showed flashes as a pass rusher during his first 2 seasons on the field. Then, as a senior, he had an impressive 65 tackles and 10.5 sacks during his senior season, earning first-team All-AAC honors under head coach Matt Rhule. Reddick accepted an invitation to the Senior Bowl. During the event, he was moved to inside linebacker and impressed scouts and team representatives after excelling in practice. He had a game-high 9 tackles, helping vastly improve his draft stock. Reddick was one of the fastest risers during the draft process, going from a maybe top 100 prospect to top 20. He completed every drill at the NFL Combine, where he had an 11-foot-1 broad jump, the best for a defensive lineman since 2003, and a 4.52 40-yard dash that was best among defensive linemen at the draft. He also participated at Temple's Pro Day. Reddick was compared to Ryan Shazier. Scouts called him an ascending prospect with a high-end potential if he can continue to hone his craft. He was projected to be a first-round selection and was ranked either the best or second-best linebacker in the draft. After being taken by the Cardinals, Reddick competed for the starting inside linebacker job. He was called the backup money linebacker by Bruce Arians coming into the season. He played sparingly, recording 26 tackles, 2.5 sacks, and 2 forced fumbles as a rookie. The most notable event that's happened in his career up to this point was during his rookie campaign when he was ejected after getting into a skirmish with Carlos Hyde. Since his rookie season, Reddick has become a role player for Arizona. He has 156 tackles and 5 sacks over the span. The Detroit Lions own the 21st pick, where they took Florida linebacker Jared Davis. Davis attended Camden County High School in Kingsland, Georgia. He recorded 114 tackles and 3 forced fumbles for the Wildcats as a senior. Originally, Davis committed to play college football for Auburn, but flipped to Florida. With the Gators, Davis played in every game as a freshman and missed 3 as a sophomore due to a torn meniscus. Over the span, he had 47 tackles. He emerged as an elite talent during his junior season, making 98 tackles and 3.5 sacks. Davis followed up his junior year with 60 tackles and 2 sacks as a senior, playing only 9 games due to an ankle injury. He was named second team All-SEC for his efforts. Unfortunately, the injury hindered him from participating in the Senior Bowl and later the NFL Combine. After recovering, Davis took part in Florida's Pro Day. Scouts said that Davis was to be praised for both his football and personal character. Davis has athletic gifts to go along with the character traits teams are looking for. He was projected to be a first or second round selection and was slotted as the second or third best inside linebacker in the draft. After being selected by the Lions, Davis won the starting middle linebacker gig in training camp. He started off his career with an impressive debut, making 9 solo tackles and recovering a fumble against the Cardinals. He recorded his first career sack the next week against the Giants, but suffered a concussion in the contest that held him out of the next 2 games. Davis made 96 tackles and 2 sacks on the season, being named to the PFWA All-Rookie Team. He followed it up with a solid second season, making 99 tackles and 6 sacks for the Lions. Davis has found a good role with the Lions and has shown great ability to play at the next level. In 2019, he had 63 tackles, 2 sacks, and 3 forced fumbles in 11 games before going down with an injury and landing on injured reserve. Missouri linebacker Charles Harris was selected with the 22nd pick by the Miami Dolphins. Harris attended Lincoln College Preparatory Academy in Kansas City, Missouri. Harris didn't play football until his junior year of high school. It's safe to say he figured it out pretty quick, making 40 tackles and 6 sacks. Then, as a senior, he had 60 tackles and 12 sacks, but Harris did much more than play defense on the Blue Tigers football team. He had 15 receptions for 285 yards and 5 touchdowns during his senior season. Additionally, he played basketball and boxed during high school. Harris committed to Missouri to play football. He redshirted and then appeared in every game the following season, making 19 tackles and 2 sacks. In 2015, as a redshirt sophomore, Harris took over a starting role and excelled, posting 56 tackles tackles, and 7 sacks. He earned second team All-SEC honors for his performance. Harris followed it up with 61 tackles and 9 sacks as a redshirt junior. He made second team All-SEC again and decided to declare for the draft. After participating at both the NFL Combine and Missouri's Pro Day, he was projected to be a first or second round selection. Scouts called Harris a high-cut pass rusher with good athleticism but concerns regarding his ability to drop anchor against the run. Harris was considered as both a defensive end and linebacker at the draft, later playing outside linebacker for the Dolphins after being drafted. He had a limited role in Miami as a rookie, making 19 tackles and 2 sacks, which remains his career high. Over the next 2 seasons, he sat out of 7 games and had only 42 tackles and 1.5 sacks. Harris has found a role in the pros, but it is quite small. As you can probably conclude, these 3 teams would be better off with TJ Watt today. Watt has established himself as one of the game's top defensive talents and is furthering the dominance attached to the Watt name. It took TJ Watt a lot of work to get to the pros, but after making it big, he hasn't disappointed. Already a 2-time Pro Bowl selection and All-Pro after 3 seasons, who knows what's next for the young linebacker. The Steelers got a gem in Watt late in the first round, and those teams who passed over him feel it when he steps up on the other side of the ball. This has been Who Was Drafted Before TJ Watt?